Jacob is in no man's land. He's out there between a familiar place and an unfamiliar place, a dangerous place, a lonely place, the way you and I often are when we're asleep. And we dream. And sometimes we dream nightmares, and sometimes we dream good dreams, and sometimes, on rare occasions, it's hard to tell the difference. Well, when I was your age, boys and girls, I actually was once. It's hard to believe, but I actually was once. I used to go to church camp. It was called Pennington Island. It was, I thought it was just a, it was a really special place. Sometimes it was in the middle of the Delaware River near Philadelphia, but sometimes when we would go there in July or August, the river was high, and so you couldn't drive onto the island. You basically went on to, you kind of, there was, usually there was maybe that much water, and so the cars would come from the mainland across to Pennington Island, just not much wider than this aisle. And our parents would get rid of us for a couple of weeks, and they'd drop us off, and we thought that they were doing a great thing by sending us to camp. They thought they were doing a great thing because they were going to have some time with each other. And they knew we would be well cared for. But Pennington Island, and many of you here, how many of you have been to church camp? Okay. A lot of you. What happens at church camp? You know, don't tell me. I know. I mean, there all kinds of things happen at church camp. Well, what I want to share with you, we used to sing an old camp song that had to do with this morning's Old Testament text of Jacob's dream, called Jacob's Ladder. You remember? Sing it with me. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. Soldiers of the cross. We are climbing. Every rung goes higher, higher. Every rung goes higher. Sinners, do you love my Jesus? 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 Soldiers of the cross. If you love him, why not serve him? 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 Soldiers of the cross. Do you think I'd make a soldier? Do you think I'd make a soldier? Do you think I'd make a soldier? Do you think I'd make a climbing higher, higher.
We are climbing higher.
I remember that at camp. And I remember, we're Presbyterians, we're not Baptists, we're not Pentecostals. Mama were here, he'd object. He'd say, well, we're Pentecostal. Anyway, it's too bad we're not. But the way that we used to give our lives to Christ was we all had these popsicle sticks. Anybody else ever do this? I hope not. Anyway, they gave us all popsicle sticks around the campfire at night. A big bonfire out there. And after singing that song, we were invited to give our lives to Christ. And the way you did it was you threw your popsicle stick on the fire. You just went forward, put your popsicle stick on the fire. So my popsicle sticks been burning since I was about 13 years old. And I've been still trying to understand what it was I did then and what it means to be a soldier of the cross. Well, do you know where this song comes from? It doesn't come from a white church camp. It comes from the slave fields. It's the slaves who are suffering, picking cotton, bleeding, their hands and their feet bleeding from picking the cotton in the cotton fields on the plantations that were singing this. We are climbing Jacob's ladder, we are climbing higher, higher. Soldiers of the cross, not soldiers of the militia, or soldiers of the plantation owner who was keeping us in place. We are climbing higher, which meant north. North, up. We are climbing our way to freedom. Soldiers of the cross. Soldiers, what is a soldier of the cross? A soldier of the cross is somebody who engages in conflict without firing a shot. These slaves understood themselves to be the brothers and sisters of Jesus, who was nailed to the cross, who suffered, whose hands bled just like theirs did, whose feet bled just like theirs were bleeding out in the cotton fields. So to sing Jacob's Ladder, you could just hear the slaves singing out there, just kind of quietly singing out there in the fields. We are climbing. And they knew exactly what they were talking about. Now, the interesting thing for me as I've studied this over the years is, and looked at the text more carefully, there is a way in which we, Protestants especially, it's curious because we think of the Catholic tradition as the one that that we broke with, because we believe that one is saved by grace through faith, not by works, and the old line was that the Catholic tradition said you're saved by works. Anyway, the way in which this dream gets twisted is that we think the ladder is we are climbing up the ladder to heaven. We are climbing the ladder to God. Well, that's not what the text says. We don't set the ladder up in Jacob's dream. He sees a ladder that is set up from heaven to earth, on the earth. And angels are descending and ascending, going back and forth to where he is. He's not ascending. They're ascending and descending. And at the end of it, he says, surely God is in this place, and I did not know it. And the name of the place before it became known as Bethel, house of God, was Luz. So just little old Luz, wherever that is, out in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of, in this place, in between place, where Jacob is wrestling with, what am I gonna do when I meet Esau? When Esau comes to me, he's gonna strangle me. So he's gonna kill me. He has a right to kill me. I stole his birthright. Right there, in the middle of this transition time of great insecurity and anxiety in Luz, he understands that Luz, right here, is the house of God. I don't have to climb that ladder. It's right here. How about that? What do you think? Is it true? Times of great anxiety, times of turmoil, times of trouble, times when conscience nags us, moments of the past that keep cropping up, these insects that just keep showing up and eating away at us, at our hearts and our minds. Fears about tomorrow. What's going to happen tomorrow? It's going to happen when I show up and when Esau shows up. Paul has an answer for that. Psalm 137 has an answer for that. If I descend to the uttermost parts of the sea, even there you are present. There, even there, your left hand shall hold me and your right hand shall lead me. I think one of the great mistakes that we sometimes make, we human beings, all human beings, is to think that we belong somewhere else. Kind of strange, isn't it? What are we doing here if we belong somewhere else? God is in this place. God is in this place, and God is in your bodily existence here and now. You don't have to wait until heaven. You don't have to wait till death. Feel it now. Breathe now. Take a deep breath. Where'd that come from? I just breathed out. Where does that come from? We've talked about this before. What is the Hebrew name for God? The name that cannot be spoken. So whoever wants to sin, go ahead and give me the name. YHWHLY. Breath. Yahweh. He's breathing in you right now. The breath is breathing in you. If it weren't breathing in you when you exhaled, you would not inhale again. Would you? We are created in the image of God. We are not God, but we are created in the image of God. And our calling is to live more humbly, to get with the program that we are not supposed to be any other place than where we are right now. Right now, sitting in the pews at Shepherd of the Hill Presbyterian Church. Not, I'm going to Vermont this week, Ted. Do you have a cell phone? Give me just a minute here. I want to look up. And we're going up to Quebec City, you know. Oh, my goodness. I want to be in Quebec City. I do want to be in Quebec City. But I don't want to get to Quebec City before I get there. I want to be where I am right now, present, fully present here to you. You fully present to me. That's what the dream of Jacob is about. So the Lord bless us and keep us, bring to our knowledge that surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. Amen.